Franklin County judge poses for a picture with a popular prankster. She says it didn't seem like a big deal, but Columbus police are calling the photo unprofessional and disrespectful. 10 TV's Maureen Kosat is live near the Ohio State University campus to explain the controversy. Maureen.
And well, we're going to let you at home decide. Now, the story really begins right here at the intersection of Woodruff and High here near the Ohio State University campus. It's a pretty busy intersection, so there were witnesses when those pranksters pretended to bash into an ATM machine. Now, earlier this week, a judge acquitted the pranksters of any criminal charges. That's not what has police so upset.
The pranksters posted the ATM stunt on the popular video website YouTube, along with a conversation with Columbus police officers who weren't laughing.
You're putting our lives at risk, and you're putting other people's lives at risk because we're running our lights and sirens trying to get here because we think somebody's trying to rob us.
I understand.
This week, a Franklin County judge found four defendants not guilty of disorderly conduct and inducing panic. It's what happened after the judge's ruling that has some police officers upset. A post-trial photo of the pranksters posing with the judge, one of them making a heart with his hands right over the head of Judge Ann Taylor.
It's a rare situation. I just responded to a request to take a picture.
The Fraternal Order of Police, the union representing the officers, calls the picture demeaning and unprofessional.
The fact of the matter is we don't taunt, we don't celebrate when we win. We don't have mass amounts of officers showing up and taking celebratory photos from our perspective. It's disrespectful.
Judge Taylor says, on the contrary, she was very impressed with the officers who testified in her courtroom.
I think they used good judgment in this matter. I would be quite surprised if there was pushback from the officers, the two officers who testified in the trial.
The judge may get the chance to find out because not long after the acquittal, the pranksters posted a new stunt, more fake ATM robberies that could prompt more 911 calls to police.
One second. No, you're fine. You can wait. Now, we do want to show you here at this intersection. If you look, you'll see there is not actually an ATM here. It was purchased by the pranksters for the purpose of the stunt, so there was no criminal damage to any property. Live near the Ohio State University campus, Maureen Kosat, 10 TV News.